the next challenge is we have to overlay this menu bar on this particular slider folder here. So in that essence, let's get back to stylesheet.css, and here we can see that this is the menu holder, this is the slider holder, and this is the main wrapper, which is practically wrapping both this slider and this menu bar into it. So in that essence, the very first thing that we need to do, in order to gain some overlay condition, we have to change the Z index property of all those things, those being used over here. So in that essence, the very first thing that we are going to do, we are going to make this slider holder into an absolute position. And in that very case, if we wish to use some absolute condition into our project, we have to define the parent block element with a position of relative. So that is why in this main wrapper, we are keeping this position as relative. This is the first case. Why main wrapper? Because it is practically wrapping each and every element, like this menu holder. This is the main child element to this particular main wrapper, and another child element is slider holder. So main wrapper is the parent holder, menu holder is the first child element, and the slider holder is the second child element. And all we are doing here, we are practically lifting the slider holder div on or over, not over, practically below this menu holder. And this menu holder item, where it goes, this menu holder blocked item, it is practically going to be overlaid on this particular slider holder, and that is what we are about to do into our stylesheet.css. So we have kept the parent element with a position of relative, and now in this particular slider holder element, we are putting this position as absolute. There it goes. And we are mentioning that it will be 0 ticks from the top. That means it won't be leaving any kind of margin from the top. This is the second case. Now if we leave it up to this far, and if we get back to our project and reload, we will see that this will be result, but this is not the exact desired one. The menu holder is right now beneath this particular slider holder block level element. So this is what we need to change right now. In that order, all we are going to do, we are going to put the Z index to -1, and we are going to lift the Z index of this menu holder item to some value, for say 9999. Now if we press Ctrl S, get back to our project and reload, now we can see that actually the menu bar item, it is all over this individual slider holder panel. And we can see that both the slider holder and the menu bar, both of them are practically working. Now press Ctrl Shift M, first of all, put it back to 480 pixels. This will be the best resolution. Reverse it, and you can see that the slider panel, it is practically working, and there's absolutely no problem with this slider panel. So everything is right back into its position. It is practically doing the best fit thing into our project. So we can say that we have successfully placed the menu holder above this particular slider holder, but there's another problem. We can see that already the H1 tag, those were being used over here, those have now been disappeared under this particular menu holder right into it, right over here. So this H1 tag, it is practically lying beneath this menu holder. Now we have to rectify them too. So all we need to do, we need to press F12, then we need to select this particular P tag, and we can see that this is the H2 tag which is practically lying beneath this particular menu holder. So we need to get back to it, and we can see that this is the H2 tag which is been used over here, and it is using a margin of 2.33 rem. So what if we put a line height here, or say a line height of 5 rem. Now we can see that this particular H2 tag, it is now resurfacing from the below, from the bottom of this particular menu holder item, menu holder block level element. So in that essence, we need to change the line height of this H2 class, which is being used with this particular slider holder right over here. And we need to change them a little bit more. So instead of 5 rem, if we put it 7 rem, we can see that everything is right back into the position. There it goes, everything is right back into this position. So all we need to do now, let's get back to our project. And here we are practically modifying the line height of this carousel slider, which in turn is lying into the slider holder block level element. So that is why we need to get back to our text editor, and here we will be wishing to mention as H2, which is under this slider holder. So we can see that there it goes, slider holder H2, and we have changed the line height. Sorry, this is not line 4 height, this is line height. Printing mistake, I guess. 7 rem, important, there it goes. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and run. And we can see that we have successfully changed the line height of this H2 tag that we are working with right over here, and everything is back into its position. So if we press Ctrl Shift M, reload, there it goes, and we can see that there's absolutely no problem with the slider, with the menu bar, with any of the components. Those are present right into the slider holder or into the menu holder items. So everything is fine, and the slider panel, it is practically closing in, or it practically closes off, whatever we wish to do with it. Each and every components, those are practically right now working as it should have been. So we have successfully implemented our menu holder over our slider holder element, and if we wish to change the color of this particular menu holder, then there's absolutely no problem with it too. All we need to do, we need to get back into our project, into our text editor, and we may use, if we use it over here with this menu holder till reload, no, it won't be working. So let's find out which one is responsible for menu holder, for this color change here. Div class nav wrapper, nav. So this is the background color. So this is the class which is practically responsible for this background color. So we need to copy this class from here, get back to your project, into this stylesheet.css, put the nav, the background color here should be, for say, transparent. So this is the background color of transparent, or to this particular class of nav. And on the other hand, in this index.html, we have used this class name of till along with the menu holder item, the child item that we have created. into our project. Now let's get back to our project. First of all, close this code inspector panel and reload. It is not working. No problem. So this is the component that we need to change right over here. We have set its background to transparent. And this is the menu holder tilt item that we have created over here. We have practically used this tilt class with this particular class of menu holder. And this is what the result, the exact result will be. So we can see that everything is right now into its location, into its position. Everything is right into its order. So we have successfully created the slider panel and the menu bar component, and we have placed them overlaid on one over another. And in the next case, all we are going to do, we are going to create, make it into the desktop preview. We are about to create this particular segment here, which practically uses all those Google apps or Google icons into it, with it. And we are going to use some kind of grid section right over here. So on the other hand, I would like to ask you to do not forget to subscribe us, and do not forget to hit that particular bell icon in order to stay connected with us. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next tutorial. Till then, bye.